Right, guys, Jed Walters here. Today I'm down at Manston Golf Centre on the outskirts of Broadstairs and Ramsgate. These are officially Ramsgate in Kent. And I am with what you know as Lloydie Golf from Instagram. Lloyd, welcome. We are here today because we're going to start our series. It is Captain Caveman's Golfvolution. We are going to turn this guy into a player. We're going to do it over however long it takes. We're going to be looking at running these episodes out weekly on a Monday evening. So you need to make sure you click the subscribe button. You also need to make sure that you follow Instagram, both Instagrams. And also, you're going to get loads of little weekly updates and snippets from what Lloyd's going to do on his YouTube channel as well. So hop over to his YouTube channel, make sure you click that button as well. Post your comments in the box below, as always, because the more interaction we get from you guys, the more we're going to try and help you as well at the same time as helping Lloyd. So we're outside here. It's a nice day. It lasted down all night on my journey down here. But we're here, we're outside. We're going to get lots of great information. We're going to go in part one through just his basic golf swing. So first of all, and we're going to get Lloyd just hit some shots. We're going to have a little look at those shots in greater detail. I'm going to record them separately in slow motion. So then we're going to have a look at them, discuss what it is. We're going to use lots of technical stuff. We're going to break that down into layman's terms. And we're going to start to see a change pretty quickly in how the contact with the golf ball and the overall ball flight, overall outcome, which is the biggest thing that we want to fix, is able to be put in place. So no matter how bad you may think it is when you're out there hitting it, sometimes slight changes make a big difference to your outcome. You don't have to go for a golf lesson and go backwards before you go forwards. You should always start to go forwards. It may not be as fast as you think it needs to be or you would like it to be, but you should always make progress if you go for a lesson. So when you go see your pro, make sure that you're moving forwards as you go through. Right, we're going to start. We're going to get Lloyd to hit half a dozen shots. We've got camera on this angle here, so we'll wait for this camera, which is I've got my back to as we go through there. So we're going to hit some shots. We're going to get some down the target line view. We're going to get some face on view from here. I'm going to record a few shots on my iPad as well. At stages, we're going to bring in gadgets. We're going to use technology from Live View Golf. We're going to use SkyTrack. We're going to use SkyPro. Lots of other little different things, tennis balls, alignment sticks, everything like that. Just so that we can help the understanding and the feelings of what we want become a little bit easier to feel and to flow as we go through. So first thing we're going to do is we're just going to get half a dozen shots that we throw a few balls out here. We've got a mid iron in play, so we've got a 7 iron in play there. And we're just going to hit some shots. We're going to pick out a target. So for the guys who are looking from behind, and when you're looking on this down the target line view, this 50-yard banner, which is right in front of us, this is the target line, putting it out over here into the distance of the little ball on the bottom.
So 50 yards from here, yeah.
So we're going to hit the shots. We're going to fly over this 50-yard banner. No pressure, mate. No pressure whatsoever. Little draws for the cameras. Thank you. We've got a couple more.
So looking at these two swings here, face on down a target line view, lots of great things going on. Really nice setup position down a target line view, with the exception we've got a fraction too much knee flex. But we're not going to look at that in a minute because I want to put a piece of the puzzle in place, which is going to feel that movement slightly more exaggerated. So we'll hold that extra knee flex as we are for now. Looking at it from face on angle, the shaft is a little bit more sort of vertical there. We will start to see that move a little bit further forward as we develop. So staying on that face on view, movement away is fairly nice. We get into a fairly nice sort of body rotation, not too turned of the upper body as the club gets into this parallel to the ground position here. But what we do notice is the knee flex in that trail knee, that right knee, not only stays in quite some way there, but it also moves the pressure a little bit to the outside of that foot, so it moves beyond the parameter of your width of stance there. In a downswing then from here, we've made a good upper body turn. As we're coming down here, we get a little bit of upper body, hands, arms dominating the downswing. Lower half of the body doesn't kick in until almost halfway down. Then we come through towards our impact. We've got the shaft leaning a fraction forward, which is not too bad as we go through here. We've got a little bit of a sort of scooping action happening here, which you'll see as we go through. And we continue with this wrist position, this lead wrist, as we go through. As we're trying to sort of help the ball off the ground, we see this lead wrist, especially at this point, try and guide and steer and help the ball up, and that's why we get our inconsistencies in whereabout we bottom out with the golf swing. So the lowest point varies. At times it can vary between sort of 6 to 8 inches. Looking at it from down our target line view, we are going to see that really nice movement back, that nice relationship there between the left arm and the shaft. Really, really good. Keeping it moving up to the top, this is where we can see that knee flex retained all the way there. We'll look to get our arms a little bit higher at the top of the backswing there. We can see the time it takes for the left hip to really engage and start to turn. At this point, the hands and arms are moving quite some way down. So a lot of swing direction is really nice. It's a little bit better off to the right-hand side, which is fantastic. Our lowest point, our contact point, always remains that little bit more inconsistent, and we can see there how vertical we are as we go through into the exit point there. You know, if we look at the entry point, it's down here, exit route is really, really vertical as we go through, and then round into the fish.
Right guys, so having had a look at the swing itself and breaking it down, we can see there's loads of great pieces in this puzzle. But we've seen there those two key elements that we really need to change: the knee flex and where the dominance is in the downswing that's going to come through. So we're going to start with those points. We're going to work those in as two key swing thoughts. They are going to be the only key swing thoughts for this episode. And Lloyd's going to just practice and practice and practice them. So when the next episode, it's going to be feeling a little bit more natural. You know, the amount of time he's putting into his golf, the it'll start to feel quite natural then by the time episode 2 comes around, and then we can put the next change in. Too many swing thoughts is bad. You can really only cope with 2. If you're going to have 2, it's 1 going back and 1 downswing. If you're other than that, 1 is the maximum then, whether it be a backswing or a downswing or an impact point. Okay, so we're going to start in the backswing, and we're going to get the feeling of this right knee losing some flex. It's going to feel like it's locked.
Yeah, correct.
So it won't be, as we'll see from Dan's target line view, you guys are going to see that his right knee isn't going to lock out. It's going to straighten. Okay? I know the keyboard is ready, stack and tilt's about to get powered into the comments at the bottom there. It's not. What it is stabilizing the lower half of the body so you can then be dynamic and moving forward, okay? So to feel that the pressure goes into the right position, we're gonna use half a tennis ball. So we're gonna make some practice swings first. So just take your setup for a second, just into that space. Okay, right, I don't know whether you guys can see, I'm gonna have a little look on the camera there. You might be able to, you might not. We'll get a close up of it. Here, I've just sprayed some dry shampoo as a line. So this is sort of indicating the lowest point of our golf swing. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna put this tennis ball underneath his right heel into there. Okay, so I want the pressure now in the start, and this is a drill. If you guys get a little bit too much outside here, this is a great drill. So we're gonna start with the heel a little bit off the ground, only a fraction. We're just taking the pressure off so we can see it's not quite squashed under there. Now, when Lloyd's going to make his backswing, he's going to crush that tennis ball with his heel. So that's going to show that the pressure is turning into this heel here. He's not staying forward. He's not moving too much on the outside. He's turning into this heel. So we're going to make a backswing and hold that position at the top now. So the right knee's going to straighten back. The right heel is going to crush the tennis ball as we do it. So we'll go to the top and hold the position. So we can clearly see there from the front, it's not leaning forward, yeah? So you don't need to get the keyboard out, typing away now. So we're into a great position in here, pressure's into the heel, and as you can see, we've still got flex in this angle. It's great, it's not as obvious. Now, the second key point is the way that he moves. We've seen that these dominate the downswing. Now it's gonna be from the ground. We're gonna use the belt buckle, and we're gonna turn it to face the target. So the first movement Lloyd's going to make now is turning his belt buckle to face the target. The club, as he keeps going, we'll keep going, mate, and as he keeps going, swinging down, swinging and keeping it going. And as we go through here, we can see from down our target line view that this lead wrist isn't hyper-extended here, now it's going this way. So the exit route of the golf club is going to improve, it's going to get better. So we're going to make a few practice swings now to get the feeling. Now, when we make a practice swing, we need it to be almost identical to what we want to do in the golf swing. So this line here replicates the low point. This is the point that the club needs to hit the ground. When the golf ball comes in play, it's going to be there. It's going to be just behind, because at the minute we've got such a variation on where that piece is. So we actually want the divot to be line and forward. So we're going to start making some practice swings to get the feeling first. So we're making that backswing, so we're going to crush the tennis ball as the right knee straightens, and we're going to turn the belt buckle to face the target into the finish. Let's make two practice swings, mate. Beautiful. You guys probably can't see that. I'm actually going to get my phone out and get some footage there. Let me just get an impact.
It's weird because in practice I'd never do that.
So that is, if you look at the line there, that point here is literally just where the club has bottomed out there. Right, which is brilliant, because that now shows that the movement going this way is taking the club into the right place. We're going to make one more practice one. And if we take a divot out on that line, brilliant. Okay, so the one thing we notice there is the divot is this side of the line. Again, let me just get an image there so we can put the two images together so we can see where that started. So that there tells us that we were still, like we would do because it's a new movement, a little bit too dominant in the top half of the body, in the downswing, not had enough from the bottom half. Okay, so our key swing foot, we're going to hit some shots. So we're going to straighten the right knee. And then we're going to turn the belt buckle, let everything else follow in the downswing and through. What happens to the golf ball doesn't really matter on this first view because we're thinking about this as a new movement. So it's right knee and turn. Okay, and again. So if we look at where the finish position is, when we made that great practice swing, we noted how much rotation there was. And the upper body's facing over there, belt buckle's facing way down the left half of the range. Okay, just feel those hands a fraction forward over that. So, just going to keep a bit more this way, three, four positions. That's it. Okay. Get a little bit more speed. So we'll put that in there. We'll make a practice swing first. So just shuffle the feet back a fraction. Just make that practice swing. So, all about that hip turning and down. So speed of the hips. Well, keep it nice and constant. That's it. It's good. And again. Good. Okay, and again, let's get a little bit more on this one now, a little bit on that side of the divot. Extend the divot the other side of that line. Lovely. So now here's the contact. We've extended that divot there really, really nicely. Again, so we can see that we know where the original divot position was. Now we can see where that's been extended, the far side of the line. So, you know, ultimately we can say, well, fundamental number one isn't take your grip or stand in this way. It's where we get the club to hit the ground. You know, it's fundamentally important that the club hits the ground here so that it's just fractionally target side of your golf ball. You know, you watch all the guys on TV and that's what they do. 99.9% of the time, their golf club is hitting the ground this way, not this way. So if we get this position here, the lowest point of the swing in a more constant place, we are instantly going to hit the golf ball with more speed, we're going to hit it better, everything's going to start to flow. We can make that swing there that we've just made, this will be fantastic. So again, don't worry about the ball because we're not really looking to hit the ball, we're looking to hit the line. The ball becomes that little bit of a byproduct of what we want to do. So straighten the right knee, belt buckle to target. Almost. Okay, we'll try two more and then we're going to bring in a little drill which is going to change a little bit of the focus and increase a little bit more confidence in not worrying about hitting the golf ball. Because one of the biggest things that we look at when the ball's on the floor is we want to help it up, we want to get it up off the ground. Okay. Right, so practice drill. We're going to take setup to our line here, but I'm going to increase that line and move just a little bit. So I want you to tell me when you feel comfortable. Really good? Okay, close your eyes. Keep them closed. And I want you to feel the movement. We're going to make a back swing, straightening the knee. We're going to make a down swing by firstly moving the belt buckle, nothing else, and keeping it turning through. We want to feel the club hit the ground, and that's it. Okay, when you're ready. Almost, hang on. Beautiful. So now we look at where we hit the ground, taking our line away.
How is it?
Yeah. And it's nice and shallow, isn't it? It's just a little sliver that you're taking away. And again, so same again. So taking a setup position. Closing your eyes. Same movement, just remember the movement. See what happens. Brilliant, we've hit the same point again. Look at this, we've actually taken this divot even further forward.
How weird.
And again, one more.
It's been strange because I can't see that.
Right, so the club on those three is bottomed out in a very similar place. So let's get rid of wives tail number one. Keep your eye on the golf ball. Don't, doesn't matter. Look at where it's flying. Don't keep your eye on the golf ball. Retain your height and your posture and move in the right way. We want the club to bottom out in the right position. Whether we look at it or not is relevant because if I'd have put a ball there and your eyes were closed, I'd have watched a great golf shot.
Yeah.
Simple. So it's about motion and practicing with your eyes closed, and even hitting shots with your eyes closed is a great thing because what we'll find is that we start to trust the movement rather than focusing on moving the object. And that is probably our biggest thing to get over, is it's not about moving the object, it's having the movement move it as a consequence, as a byproduct.
Yeah.
Okay. So we say, right, okay, well, right now we know the movement with our eyes closed.
Yeah.
Right. So we'll set up to the golf ball. We're going to feel ready. Okay. Remember the movement. Close your eyes. Okay. I know the first thing you're thinking is, where's it gone? I did. Yeah, first time right. this trip was like, oh no, where's it gone? Don't worry about it, because we're just making a movement, trying to find the club to hit the lowest point on the ground again. So let's make a swing in that feeling of memory, movement, back swing, lower half of the body down swing. See what happens. There we go. Well, if we look at that, we say, well, okay, the ball's not moved, we've made contact with it. But when it was relevant, it's trust in this movement.
Yeah, of course. Yeah.
Okay. So right knee comes in, and then it's bottom first, upper body second. Brilliant. Where'd it go, he says?
Come on, there.
So the guys from down the car go out, will have seen it starting in between the 50 and the 100 with a little bit of right to left, and he's finding the yellow flag.
Okay, yeah.
So we can now say, and you can stand on the golf course now and say, come on, Lloyd, I can hit this with my eyes closed.
Literally. Oh, good, you can, yeah. That's really weird, because I don't expect to do that.
Yeah, because this is about repeating the same motion. The more we repeat the motion, the more we don't have to worry about this. It's all making sure that the motion is right, knowing that if I don't do anything else to counteract it, balls can go.
I guess because that motion's ground in, you're always going to hit the same position every time, regardless of whether your eyes are shut or not.
Whether you're looking, whether you're facing over there, whether you're looking behind you, it doesn't really matter. We've got the body in a position. If we move the club around that position of the body in the right order, the club and the ball will meet. The ball's not going to go anywhere. We've just got to get rid of the thoughts that tell us that I've got to help the ball move. When the golf club gets that ball to move,
Because
we move the club moves the ball.
Yeah.
Okay, that's it. Another one with our eyes closed, and then we'll hit a couple eyes open. Beautiful. Now, we've sneaked a bit of turf and ball together, tiny little slither of ground there. But again, eyes closed, we've gone from first one coming off the toe and going to the right because we still had that thought of, oh no, where is it, and I'm going to miss it. It's the first thing that comes into your head.
Yep.
Then the second one is, well, I've actually made contact with that, so it's there, it's not going anywhere. Okay, we'll get that one. It's gone a bit thin, but it's away. And then the third one, we get a little bit of ground and ball. Right, so we know that ball isn't going to go anywhere. We just need to make sure that we move in the right way. So we'll finish this exercise then with just hitting a normal shot. Eyes are going to be open, but we still just need to keep that focus. Okay, so focus is on this portion here, this bit of divot, and then we just want to make that movement. We've made it from memory, we've made it with our eyes closed. Let's just make the same movement, knowing the ball's not going to go anywhere until you deliver. Lower half of the body didn't go first. And you'll start to feel it as you go through.
Oh, I did,
You start to feel it as you go through. One more.
I'm doing my eyes shut. I should be able to do it.
Exactly. You can do it with our eyes. You can hear everybody saying it now. Come on, Lloyd. Right. So, nice clip. Ball, little bit of turf gone forward. So we're starting to get that real basic motion. Beautiful. Right, guys. So you've just watched a little pitch there. This is the key practice drill, which is going to help our two key points. What we've got Lloyd doing is narrowing the stance, feeling 65 to 70% of his pressure, his body pressure, going through his lead leg, his left leg. And then we're making little gentle, slow half swings back, and then slow, continuous belt buckle hip turns through. And he's got his most lofted club, he's got his lob wedge, and we're just pitching it out about 50 yards, okay? Now, you can also see here, if I move out the way from down the target line view, this basket is around about 2.5 to 3 feet to the right of where the golf ball is going to be and where impact is going to be. This is start direction. Because one of the key things, especially when we get armsy, dominant with the swing, everything moves a little bit too much to the left in terms of the direction of the swing. So we want to think about the swing direction being a fraction more to the right, especially on the short shots. So we're thinking about start direction being a little bit off to the right. So if we try and hit towards target, we'll have a few pulls coming in. But if we think about firing the ball toward that basket, we'll hit the golf ball pretty much on target. Okay, so set up position, weight a little forward, holding it in there, nice and relaxed, half speed back, rotation through, just a little bit faster. We've seen the previous one there, really nice control, lovely contact, nice little pinch of the turf, taking some nice little divots here as well, and just a little bit of ball turf. And again, so nice and relaxed, smooth turn, lovely. Again, fractionally squeezed a bit of turf and ball together there. Just took your club in a little tighter. Okay. Keep the tempo smooth, lovely. Arms nice and relaxed. Really, really good. Okay, so we're going to finish. This is the drill. We're also going to create it into a bit of a game for practice. So you guys out there, grab a notebook and a pen or a piece of paper and make a note of it. Physically have something you can look at. Obviously for Lloyd, you can just press play. So for him, what we're going to do is we're going to take 10 balls. And it's not a distance. It's not a direction at this point in time. It's a low point and movement test. So it's making sure that his body turns to bring the club back through the ball and into the finish, and that the point at which the club hits the ground is either pinching underneath the turf or a fraction forward of it. So it's how many out of 10? What we'll do as we go through, we will be having different types of challenges and tests right at the end so that we can measure at each point what we're doing, the improvement, how the practice has been going. You guys will obviously see the snippets of practice on Instagram, on his YouTube channel as well. So if you're not subscribed and you're not following, make sure you do. So we're going to start now. We're going to hit 10 shots. Okay. We can make a practice swing before each one because a practice swing is your dress rehearsal. We want to get the feeling, we want the club to pinch the turf, little hip rotation, nice and smooth. Okay, and again, so nice and smooth, gentle speed, but nice and constant, lovely. Okay, so into the shot now. So if we do one or two practice swings before we hit each shot. Okay, so we see that one was a little bit behind. A little slower in the rotation, you might have noticed there, guys, as well. So his hip turn wasn't quite as fast as where we'd like it to be. Good. Just keep the lower half of the body in the backswing a fraction quieter as you make that movement. Beautiful. Great contact. Okay, up and running. That was a practice swing. That was a practice swing. The point of contact on the ground was great. Hit a little bit of the toe side, got a little bit too close in the practice setup there. Okay. So quiet legs in the back swing as we just move the arms through. Turn. Okay, so didn't quite pinch the turf there. So we're 1 from 3 so far. So a little behind, and the one thing you'll notice here, I'm just going to make a slight change because we would have seen really nicely on the first one. When we make our back swing, so making the back swing, keep the legs really quiet. So just looking here, that's it, and then it's turning through. And so we don't have to have the big full finish. Don't need to here because we're only pitching it out. It's strange how short a motion will move the ball 40-50 yards. Beautiful. Right. Two really, really good quality ones there. That's it. It's nice. Okay, so a little bit hands, arms driven into your golf ball there, and that's where when we get the upper half of the body going before the lower half of the body, that's where we see the real change in where the club's going to find the ground. Okay, that's good. Brilliant. Okay. Two more to go, is it?
Yeah.
This. Fraction ground before there again, so a little bit more driven by the arms rather than being your little rotation through. Underneath, so not too bad there. So, you know, we're looking at that there, and we're around about 50% there, closer, aren't we? So, 45, 50%. So, what we need to do is, and this is the drill that we're going to practice.
Yeah.
Practicing it on grass is great because it gives you the proper feedback. Practicing it on a mat will mask. If we were on a mat, you'd be looking at a 75% success rate there, simply because of the give and the bounce that we get from the mats. So if you can practice it on grass, it's always a good way to do it. If you can't, get a piece of chalk, draw a line on the mat, and that would be your low point, and have the golf ball either, depending on how thick it is, if it's a thin line behind it, if it's a thick line, sat on top of it, and you've got to then make sure that you take the chalk line. That would be the way you get your feedback, rather than just hitting it and watching it, thinking, yeah, I felt okay, because you get that sort of masked feeling of whether or not it is a good outcome or not. You know the feeling wasn't great, but it looks right on the shot. So grass, if possible, because grass tells the story. When you get on the golf course, it literally sort of shows you how the contact is, exactly where it would be. Even on a day like today, where it's quite firm, if you catch it a little bit too soon, the ball just really goes more than 5 to 10 yards. Guys, post your comments in the box below. Get your fingers going on those keyboards and let us know your thoughts. Let us know how you've put any of these pieces into practice, if you do them, if you've ever thought about doing them as you go through. Obviously, make sure you go over, subscribe to Lloyd's YouTube channel. If you haven't subscribed to mine, click that button there and subscribe as well. Follow us on Instagram, because there's going to be loads more sort of behind the scenes stuff that goes on, little snippets and previews as we go through. It's been a great first start. We've made a really good change and feeling of change. The more we practice, the more you guys are going to see this. You'll see how the contact and the development of that goes right through. In episode 2, we're going to go into the longer end of the bag. We're going to look at how we want to take our feelings we've developed into our hybrids, our fairway woods, and ultimately everybody's favourite club, the driver.
Except mine.
Except this. Yeah. So episode 2, we're going to be looking at how we take what we've produced here and we put it into the longer end of the bag, so that we can find all the keys for consistency as we go through. Guys, as always, thanks for watching. Post comments, give it a thumbs up, and we look forward to seeing you again next time.
Cheers, guys.